Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. This time I'm working on another foggy landscape image on which I want to apply a darker look. So before I go on, here are the before and after images. And as always, let's go to the lens correction tab first. Then I'm going back to the top. And I think for this shot, I'm going with the Adobe Landscape Profile, just to bring out some more of those blue color tones. Also, I want to adjust the white balance a little bit, increasing the blue color tones even further by reducing the temperature. And in order to not make this too dark, I want to increase the exposure. Then maybe also increase the blacks, just to enhance this foggy look. And to bring back some contrast, I'm going to decrease the shadows. Maybe add some whites as well. And further boost the contrast a little bit. And actually, instead of increasing the exposure, I might want to decrease it a little bit. Yes, that looks way better. Okay, another thing I want to do is get back some structure in that image. And for that, I'm increasing the clarity. And I think I also want to increase the white balance. Okay. I also want to apply some minor local adjustments, mainly for the foreground. And as you can see, I have applied a gradiated filter here. And because I want to further increase the details in that area, I'm again increasing the clarity. Also, I can add a little bit of fake fog by decreasing the dehaze. Okay, I think that looks good for now. Then I need to do a little bit of color grading. First, I want to get rid of the aqua color saturation and of course some of the blue saturation. Then also apply a cold bluish color tone to the darker areas by using split toning. Maybe also increase the strength a bit. Okay, of course I'm also going to sharpen the image a little bit, not as much as I do with other pictures though, because I want to have a little bit of a blurry look for this one. And I think that's it for the Lightroom adjustments already. Now I want to switch over to Photoshop and finish this image. And of course the very first thing I want to do is to get rid of this little branch in the foreground. And to remove this one, I'm going to use the spot healing brush. And I just need to paint over this real quick. And let's get rid of some other distracting objects. Then I want to further work on the mood of the image. The next step is to add some subtle glow with the new layer and the blending mode set to soft light. Then I'm grabbing the brush tool and set the painting color to white, and then just add the glow to the picture. Also, again, this will have some kind of fake fog effect, as you can see in the foreground. Okay, now I think I want to darken the image a little bit more, so I'm applying a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Here I'm decreasing the brightness, of course, and also add some contrast. Now I don't want this adjustment layer to affect the whole image. So again with the brush and the brush opacity set to around 10%, I'm going to brush out a few spots of the image. For example, the glow on top of the image. Also, I want to have a brighter foreground. Then I'm going to merge all those layers. And then it's time to add some more blurriness, and in order to do that, I'm going to use the Nicollection plugin and then go with the classical soft focus filter and the first diffusion method. Alright, this looks nice, but I don't want to have this blurriness over the foreground, so I'm applying a layer mask on that soft focus layer. And with the black brush, I'm going to brush over this little piece of land in the foreground. Okay, let's see. Maybe I want to bring some more attention to the brighter spots. So again, I'm applying a brightness and contrast adjustment layer and increase the brightness this time. And I'm also filling this layer mask with black. And now I'm grabbing a white brush and just brush over the brighter spots a little bit. Then one last thing I like to do, because I think the image is a bit too saturated, is to apply a vibrance adjustment layer and reduce the vibrance a tiny bit. Alright, and that's it for editing this moody image. I hope this was an interesting video. And of course, if you'd like to see more content like this, then please feel free to subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for watching this video.